So today we will discuss if your grandma wanted a little dog, what would you recommend? So I say a little dog, it's not a dog for defensive purposes, but just a dog as companion. Otherwise, a completely different breed would be selected. That being said, if your grandma wants some companion, there are some breeds that I would recommend. And those breeds are, of course, because I like terriers, some are in the terrier group. I will discuss the West Highland White, and in my opinion, a better choice very often the Cairn Terrier, as well as Norwich and Norfolk from the terrier family. Also, Border Terrier could be a choice. So we'll discuss that too. And I will discuss some other breeds that I think are still very good choices, including poodle. It would be the medium or miniature poodle in this case, or miniature schnauzer. And why the miniature? I have selected a weight range that is still within the capabilities of an older person, even your grandma, to lift or to move about. A bigger dog would be very hard, especially at a certain age. So this makes it compact and also able to take with her in this case, and also with the ability to lift the dog. A Pattedale would be in the same weight range, but it's also a very nice dog, but a little bit less laid back than, for example, a Border Terrier of show lines in particular. So why the Border Terrier? It's a relaxed, laid back type of dog, and still quite healthy. That's also a parameter. Most of the dogs are very healthy in this list, and it's also quite a hard dog. It is not an excessive barker, so many of the dogs I selected are not excessive barkers. For example, Pomeranians or small Spitz are, in my opinion, and also they take a lot of work. These dogs are quite easy also to maintain. Of course, a poodle you can maintain in different ways, and then it can take also a lot more work. But especially in this situation you see here, a rainy day, mud, when you go in the field, it's hard enough for an older person to do the task that they have to do, instead of making time also for other things. West Highland White Terrier is just a very charming type of terrier, which also has a very nice character. Like the Border Terrier, also very good with children, for example. And also has a hypoallergenic coat, if that is something that you are looking for. More like human hairs instead of a coat. The drawback would be that because the white coat is that white, you will easily see some dirty points, but even that is, in my opinion, a very small point, and normally the coat stays quite clean. But the Cairn Terrier has different coats and is altogether an even more sturdy package, because the West Highland White Terrier has quite a lot of deficits lately, which is a bad thing. So I would recommend the Cairn Terrier a lot more. And if you want to go smaller, there are Norwich and Norfolk Terriers, which are predominantly red, smaller than both Cairn Terrier and the West Highland White, but a very strong, sturdy little dog for such a compact frame. These are also the smallest in the list, but I come highly recommended, much more than, for example, Yorkshire Terrier. Another thing I mentioned the poodle, and I'm not extremely a fan of poodle blood, but I like also in the Labradoodle, the poodle side more than the Labrador side. And why? Poodles are hypoallergenic, so that's a good thing. And also you can cut them in all types of coat types. Yeah, coat aesthetic, so to say, but I would keep them natural. And then they look a little bit more like a Labradoodle. But they are very healthy, and they also come in small sizes. And you're not overpaying that much as compared to a Labradoodle, for example, which also come in small sizes, but they use the small size of the poodle to get there. And also the Labradoodles that are consistently hypoallergenic carry a lot of poodle blood. So even in the 80% or more poodle bloods, especially the smaller ones, because the poodle comes in different sizes, whereas the Labrador is not. And we were looking at the mini or medium poodle, because we go to weight again, so small, medium, and large mini. So that being said, could be a nice choice. And also because poodles are very healthy normally, it's also a good thing that you have ease of mind. Another factor would be, as I mentioned, the miniature schnauzer. So miniature schnauzer is like a terrier type from Germany, first developed out of the normal standard schnauzer, which is like a rough coated pincher, so to say, in the time. And then the rough and the smooth coated were divided, resulting in pinchers and schnauzers. And the miniature schnauzer also carries some poodle blood. Also a very healthy breed. I think it's a lot more sturdy than your average poodle, which I like a lot more. Also a long lifespan. And an easy size to work with. There are also some drawbacks with all these show type of dogs that they carry oftentimes. You can see this a lot in the schnauzer, but also sometimes in West Highland White Terriers or Norfolk Norwich, that they are too blocky, that their back is too short for them to be nimble. And it's just an exaggeration of the show world, next to all the other detrimental effects. But altogether, this list of dog is healthy, strong, and quite a lot of dog for this small size. I hope you enjoy. Have a great day. The difference between a working line and a show line from the pet perspective. And I'm saying from the pet perspective because from the working perspective, there's simply no challenge. You should always go with a working line. But from the pet perspective, of course, there can be some reasons why show lines could be better. Especially if you're older or you cannot handle the character of a certain type of dog. This could be troublesome. And oftentimes the show lines are a lot more meek. And also easier to work with or keep in a bigger group. But there could also be the opposite. So if you still want a very easy going dog, could also be that a show line type of dog has less predictable character. So for example, the Bull Terriers of working lines are often very human friendly, whereas those of show lines can have a more different character. So where a working Bull Terrier will be there from a place of confidence, a show Bull Terrier could be there from a different place, sometimes being very meek and easy going, but sometimes also that much different, that they come from a place of fear. And fear is a lot less reliable than dominance, of course. Another thing is, if you still need some of the working capabilities, you might have to get 2 or 3 or 4 showbred dogs of a certain type instead of one working one, because there could be so much difference in character and also drive to do the work that you want them to do. So for example, if you need a guarding dog and you get one from performance lines, one guardian dog of performance lines could outshine 4 of show lines. So there are different things. Of course, in the guardian dog, it's also that they propose a barrier function, and of course 4 can be a lot more barrier than 1. But if they are easily to be scared or not bothering at all at protecting the property, what good are they? Another point, and that's purely going to the side of working lines. Working line dogs are often a lot more healthy, because they have to be. If they're not able to work, they are not bred, and if they are unhealthy, they are very oftentimes not able to work. Whereas a show line dog, it often only needs to look pretty. Also, there are quite a few working lines that get away with quite a lot of inbreeding, whereas in show dogs the inbreeding can be even higher or lower, depends on the program they use, but they have a lot more health issues. And the health testing is managing, it's balancing out the inbreeding depression that could arise. And the benefit of that inbreeding is that you get a dog that's a lot more predictable in outcome, character, but also build. And oftentimes also other benefits. So, for example, almost all working dogs have a good heart, so a good cardiovascular system. Also, a lot of times they have good joints, hips, muscles, a good metabolism, good speed, a good motion, all things that are natural aspects of a working dog, but quite hard to find in a show dog. But those are extreme benefits, and in my opinion, very often time, even in a family setting, a working dog would be the better choice. There could be some examples of some, or exceptions in this case. As I mentioned, when you are older, you don't have the ability to put in the work, because you have to give a working dog outlets for its energy and also physical and mental stimulation and work to do. And if you're not able to do that, also the pet show line type of dog will not be that happy, but they will cope with it a lot easier oftentimes as compared to working lines. And it could be another option, if you want a specific outlook, so how a dog should look in appearance, and you might be left with a lot of breeds that are not being worked anymore, so you're then confined to show line type of dogs. So, long story short, I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day. The dog on the leash here is my pet, a little terrier, also known as a black fell terrier. It's an earth terrier type of dog. He's from working lines, and I'm glad that the entirety of the Pattedale Terrier mainly consists of a working line, but this could shift very easily in the future, like it also did with, for example, the Russells. Have a great day.